afternoon, everyone. Today is November 5th, Saturday, 2011. At noon, 12:30 p.m. Japan Standard Time. I'm all over because I didn't sleep last night. Hello, everyone. This is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English so that you can understand Japan more. Today, we are at the Nagoya International Center at the fourth floor, the gallery room. Exhibition room, sorry, my mistake. At the Foreign Artists Exhibition 26. Foreign artists living in Nagoya, around Nagoya, Japan, came together to display their artwork. So I just wanted to show you how international community of Japan, especially Nagoya, are doing and having fun doing their art, including from professional to amateur to student to some volunteer working here and have fun, get drunk.
No.
Oh, okay. Sorry about that.
Have fun, that's for sure. Okay. Have fun.
So, without further ado, we have Mr. James Golter and Barbara with us because they are the founding members of this event. So James, we did briefly introduce from the first segment, the reverb segment, that I made a mistake. Would you explain to me what is the Foreign Artists Exhibition?
Yes, the Foreign Artists Exhibition is a very long-running event which gives the opportunities to foreign artists, that means foreigners living in central Japan who do some sort of art. We provide them an outlet for their artworks to show to the local citizens here. We started in 1986 and we're still going. So it shows there's no shortage of foreign artists, no shortage of visitors, and no shortage of space, thanks to the Nagoya International Center.
So why you guys started this international event? Linda is going to talk about, but foreign
okay.
artists, I just want to focus on the Foreign Artists Exhibition.
Right, okay, well, it started with a presentation by Barbara, actually, in 1985. Talking about her paintings.
I was 4 years old, by the way.
Slightly old. Very slightly old. Just out of nappies. And luckily, very, very fortunately, there was an official from the Nagoya International Center who was at that lecture. And after it, because there was so much interest, so many questions, other artists brought their work as well, he came up with this idea that if Nagoya International Center gave a space, then why don't we gather foreign artists together to show their work? Just one occasion. That was the original idea, just one show. But it was so popular that we were encouraged to have another one, and another one, and another one, and another one. And the years rolled past. And here we are in 2011 at the 26th Foreign Artist Show.
So yep. how much older you became?
Actually, I this is no exaggeration. I have got younger.
Oh.
But the appearance, of course, is ridiculous.
Painting is really good for the health.
True.
So Barbara, so would you share with me what is your experience doing this art?
Okay.
Are you a professional artist or?
I would call myself a semi-pro.
Oh, okay.
But my friend says I'm a professional. I do teach watercolor painting as well as produce it. I sell a few paintings occasionally, and I sell my cards. And I have illustrated some children's books, which have been published. So, but I can't make a complete living off my art. Very few artists can, you know.
Yeah.
And it's all right.
How about you, James? What is your profession? Are you a professional artist?
Well, I'm trying to be, yes.
That's a good way to put it.
But unfortunately, I have to live in my car, so it's not very...
That's not true.
No, I have a small income from the art, but it is quite a struggle.
Yeah, but you're doing it in Japan, though, right?
That's right. Yes. Yeah. And the
you should bring your art.
Well, this one is mine. Can I show
this
it?
Is Barbara's. Yes, yes, Barbara. Yes. Focus on this.
Can you,
Jan,
can you work on bringing his art here? So yeah. That's the Barbara's art that you have. So, what? So you do? So you say you do the watercolor paint?
Yeah. This is transparent watercolor, which means that there is no white paint. If you see white, it's the paper showing through. If you see a pale color, it's the paper showing through the transparent color. This one was a little bit less serious than I usually am because I thought it was time to lighten up a bit. And it's called Cupid and Little Sister Seek Cool Blue in the Lingering Summer Heat. Here in Nagoya, I speak from experience, summer lasts until November. So we already have...
It was hot yesterday.
Yes, this pear is an autumn fruit. This is an autumn flower. The grapes are autumn. This ceramic cup is in the shape of an autumn flower called the kikyo. But it's still hot. So Kipi-chan is in... well, she looks cool, doesn't she? And her little sister is in a ceramic... homemade swimming pool with a plastic goldfish. And this picture is one my mother bought 69 years ago. And when she closed up housekeeping, she said, "What do you want? I want the picture." This vase my brother made. He's a professional glass blower and professional potter. So everything has a story in it. This here is a candlestick holder, but I put a marble in instead. And most things are not used in their usual way. And that made it fun.
So you do this watercolor paint in Japan, and you do, I heard you do haiku. You do,
oh, yeah.
You kind of selling postcards.
Yeah, I also do a little bit of Nihonga. So when people ask
Japanese
me
painting.
If I speak Japanese, I say instead of studying Nihongo, Japanese, I studied Nihonga, which is Japanese painting. I like the mineral pigments that are made of crushed rock, gorgeous colors you mix with hot horse hair glue and water, and but a little bit time-consuming. Watercolor's faster.
I see. So, James, before we go into the individual artists, I forgot to cover all the art in general, all the artists, what kind of artists you have here, and how you put together artists. Would you share me those? So what kind of artists and where they are from, and then... So.
Okay, fortunately, I've having been involved since the very beginning, I've got a reasonable grasp, a reasonable memory for the range of art that we've had and the number of countries that have been represented and roughly the number of artists that have shown here since 1986. So we've had from pottery to sculpture, from haiku photography, from watercolors to oil paintings to acrylics, to installations, to paper mache sculpture, to video art, short films. No performance art. It's very much a static or a viewing experience for the visitors. Basically, from what you can hear, it's about as wide as you could imagine. Visual art.
But at least some of it is the reaction of the foreign community to being here. So a lot
sure.
of our work reflects sure. our experience in Japan.
That's right. In fact, that was one of the early ideas that the Nagoya International Center had, that they would focus on artists that were using the experience of Japan for their art. But we realized that there are a lot of artists who don't rely on being in Japan for their art, so we couldn't discriminate. And I think it's a much richer show for that, particularly for visitors who come from all around the world. And the number of countries, as I said, it's 40. What was the other thing that I said I'd remembered, but I've forgotten?
Number of artists, totally.
Yes, totally. Around about 350. I made
Amazing.
A rough assessment of the lists of names. So about 350 people or shown work here. The number of artworks, too many to mention, in 26 exhibitions. There are about between 300 and 400 separate things in this show alone. So we're way up into the thousands in terms of number of artifacts shown.
I see. So what's the hardship, difficult? I mean, did you have any, so what kind of art? For example, like photograph, you have a photography, watercolor paint.
Sure.
What kind of art you have?
Personally or in show or what?
In show in general.
Well, as I said, over the years it's ranged from all that, but in this show there's everything from installation to small videos, slideshows, to watercolors, as you've just seen Barbara's lovely work, acrylic paintings, drawings, cartoons, manga art, of course, that's popular. I can't remember anymore, actually, but it's pretty wide.
We have some craft too, like
there is some small amount of craft work, but mostly people are two dimensional. I don't mean that the people themselves. Their artwork is two dimensional.
Okay.
Photography and painting.
Okay, now, so now finally, thank you, Jan, for holding up for James.
Thank you very much.
Paint, but Jan, you should sit in front of the camera because you have been.
I am the picture carrier.
James, you have actually the great very Japanese looking art. So what is your type of your art?
Well, it's watercolor. It's pen and then painted drawings, I suppose. I call them watercolors, but to describe them accurately, they're painted drawings. I love pen and ink drawings, but I also like watercolor, so I combine the two things. Excuse me.
No, you can't.
Oh, sorry. I'm just trying out. Right. So the work that I do really is based on old traditional buildings, particularly the kind of buildings that are being destroyed in Japan and turned into car parks. I look for mostly empty houses that are falling down, and then draw them. So that it's kind of a personal conservation project. And when I do the work, I know that it's going to last longer than I will. And of course it's lasting longer than the buildings themselves.
Does this building still exist?
This building still exists, but it's in much worse condition than when I drew this. Because when a house is empty in Japan, the weather is so severe in terms of the temperature range, the cold winters, the sea wind, they deteriorate very quickly, especially the wooden walls, and the heavy tile roofs slowly weigh down. And within perhaps 5 years, the house is literally garbage. No one would buy it, no one would live in it. So it becomes a car park or another building which is far less interesting.
Let's not talk about
sad things,
but let's talk about your art that you are trying to preserve. I have the footage of your art that I shot earlier. I kind of have the feeling that your style kind of resembles the Kiyoshi Yamashita kind of style. Don't you think?
No.
Not at all.
Yamashita
Kiyoshi.
But he does woodblock prints.
Yeah,
however,
I know.
Very colorful.
However,
he traveled around all over Japan riding a bicycle at times, I believe, and Jim goes down to Chitahanto and rides his bicycle around and draws these pictures.
There is an itinerant artist
on occasion.
Right.
So
I'm outside looking for the subject, that's for sure.
But I mean, you have I kind of like how. So, how long have you lived in Japan, James?
Well, within living memory, quite a long time. Yeah, I think nearly 30 years. I don't.
Okay.
Just about living memory.
So I think you live in Japan longer than I do.
Yes, you're not 30 years old yet.
I am 31, but I lived in the U.S. for 8 years. So I only lived in Japan for 23 years or something. So you live in Japan longer than I do. That's why you can capture, you can draw Japan more than I can.
Well, it's very kind of you to say that. Japanese, I've done a lot of work, and I think any art form, the more you practice, the better you become. And it really helps if you love the work you're doing and you love the subject. So I've done a lot of them, and I hope that I'm getting better.
Yeah. So Jan, you're doing lots of great contribution to this foreign artists exhibit. Would you introduce yourself, who you are?
I help to organize the volunteers, and we have about 50 volunteers, all different types of people. I teach, and so my students volunteer. I have all age students from university age up to golden age. Past silver, and everybody volunteers and gives up their time and helps build this, helps put up the entire exhibition, and then sits at the reception desk and greets people, makes tea and coffee for people.
It's
brings
really,
in sweets, talks
really
with people. We even have like a counseling table in the back here. People
for
come
me.
In and talk. And yeah, the volunteers are really, really vital in this production.
It's true to say that without Jan's efforts and her people skills, we would have no show here. She's got not often a visible role, but she's absolutely fundamental to having this show each year.
So who's behind, I know International Center, Central Japan International Society, but Jan, like people like Jan, who's like behind, besides the artist?
Besides the artist, Linda Taki, who I believe has talked to you before or is going to talk to you in the future.
Yes.
Because she's the head of Central Japan International Society.
Okay.
And she organizes, if we need fundraising, she organizes that. If we need utensils, paper cups, food, anything, she knows where to get it really cheap.
Yep.
And she knows everybody in Nagoya. And
yeah,
outside of Nagoya, which
right.
She is really our liaison with everybody.
Okay. We'll talk about
the
community of the Nagoya later
so
after
I would say
1 o'clock.
Linda and I and Jim, and there's also one other, Andy Boone makes our postcards for us. We ask an artist to design whatever the picture might be, and then Andy Boone prints it out for us.
So why do you think that foreigners, like foreign community, we kind of have to use the foreign, but foreign community, what do you think it's what do you think it's important to have events like this, James?
Well, two reasons. First of all, there are many, many foreigners, a surprising number of foreigners who are artists. Or even if they don't consider themselves artists, they do something, some Japanese art or simple drawing even. And it's a very good encouragement to give them a forum to show the work. And the second thing is that by having such an exhibition, anyone from the Japanese community can come and see what foreigners are doing here. So it's a kind of a double or reverse or a mirror sequence of foreigners being able to show their work and local taxpaying citizens to come in and see the results of the work.
And also many of the artists are here sitting next to their work or walking around. And the art gives an opportunity for people who might be shy of talking to foreigners, you know, be afraid of talking to foreigners. They can say, oh, your painting? You know, they even if their English is limited, or they communicate somehow looking at a piece of art. Where normally many Japanese people would not approach a foreigner or get to know a foreigner. But this is a great opportunity to have something to talk about.
That's right. It touches on another advantage of the show, not just through art and culture, but through the social dimension.
Mm-hmm.
People come here to meet other people, make friends. We've had two examples of artists who've of course, male and female, who've got engaged and gone on to raise families as a result of our show.
We're a matchmaking service as well.
It's only I hear. So many different spin-offs from just having a simple exhibition.
Yeah, because when I was in the U.S. as a foreign student, you know, I was able to meet from the people all over the world. Not only I spent my life in the U.S. experiencing the international life, I mean, experiencing the American life, but also I was able to experience the international life and benefit from it.
Yeah.
So I think you are trying to create the same. So you don't have to be a student, you just have to be an artist to be kind of experience the situation.
You can be an amateur artist or a professional artist, and it's a good chance for both types of people to mingle and to study each other's art and get inspiration from other people's art.
Sure.
All right. So, thank you very much, Jan. And
yes.
So, next, I think, Eddie. It's your turn, Eddie. And I kind of like you to sit, if you don't mind.
I don't mind. You're the boss. But I
support.
Your viewers are sick of seeing me.
No. You're the organizer of this event, so you kind of have to do this.
Organizing artist.
Yeah. So now we have Eddie Lizar.
Hello, Eddie.
Thank you very much for being at the Foreign Artists Exhibition live cast. This is Katz from YokosoNews. We are live from Nagoya International Center. It is about 12:52 p.m. Saturday on November 5th, 2011. Live from Nagoya International Center, Japan. The Foreign Artists Exhibit is the exhibition of the art from the artists all over the world who happen to be in around Nagoya, Japan. So I wanted to introduce some of the artists, feature some of the artists who's involved this project. So now we have Mr. Eddie Lizar joining us. Thank you very much, Eddie. So would you introduce yourself, Eddie?
Thank you very much. Thank you so much for this interview. And all the institution people organize this event, international event every year. For Jan, it's a wonderful hair. Really, he's thinking about the any opportunity.
But Eddie, first of all, we don't have much viewer, so okay. don't worry, you don't be that. I'm sorry, but I really wanted to have more viewers. Don't be too formal.
Okay.
I want to talk about you. So where are you from, Eddie?
I born in the Bilbao, San Sebastian, but it's my family. When I have 2 years old, my family is coming from South America and Bolivia.
Bolivia.
Yes, my father is from Spain.
Spain.
Basque country.
Okay.
My mom, my grandfather is from Japan. They born in Kyushu, Kumamoto, Ken.
Okay. So you're kind of half Japanese.
Yes, I have.
Okay.
My sensei, one of the
languages. Yes. Okay, got it. So you are a mix of Bolivia, Japanese, and
Spain.
Okay, got it. So what kind of art do you do, Eddie? What kind of art do you do? What do you have today? Yes.
My style of art is a little bit no unique art, because I don't mind different technicals.
Mm-hmm.
For example, this year I make designs in cardboard.
Okay.
And Damboro.
These are paintings, aren't they?
Yes.
They're paintings.
I like it. I like it every time. I like the monochrome paintings.
You can hang this in front of that camera. You see this, so you can point. You can really get close to that camera.
Okay.
Yeah. That more like. Yes, that's what
okay.
I'm talking about, yes. So, okay.
Well,
You do those.
I painted, for example, the panoramic 3 years ago. Yes, 4 years ago, I have an exhibition in Australia. The Amazon tree collections.
Okay.
For example, all the painting in monocolor. This year, I make the portraits.
Okay.
Cardboard and black and white, just on the white painting.
So.
And.
Okay.
And this.
This portraits
war. This war really, really, really is my.
Who is this? <Sabine. laughs>
My first time I painting in full color, really, really. It's my first work in full color, because all times I paint in just in monocolor.
Who is this?
Jim Morrison, the Doors.
Yes.
It's a great painting.
Next year, probably I make a big exhibition. The name is Rock Collections, all the monster collections, the artist's face portraits.
Okay. I also went to film your artwork at your booth. So you like all these American musicians, I think. You have a Doraemon there, but
yes.
Marilyn Monroe. You have.
It's I don't like just the American musician. That is I like, for example, the blues, the jazz. John Lennon, for example, Carlos Santana is new style, is the music style.
It's an important thing that Eddie himself is an excellent musician.
Yes.
A little bit. He didn't mention that, but you should say.
Well, it's the one reason is I like it so wonderful, because the art is for me, and I give it my heart. My inspire is just an art, because I make the guitar, rumba, flamenco. Sometimes I have in different live house in Nagoya. It's very amazing for me, because it's always time. It's my heart is my feeling is very so happy, and helping me every time. And my real work is a graphic designer, a web designer. Art for me is my life.
Excellent.
So you professionally web designer?
Yes.
In Japan, in Nagoya.
Yes.
Then you do play music. You do play. You do paint. Oh my God! You are multi talent.
It's true.
You are multi talent. Awesome. So why did you decide to move to Japan? Well, your family is Japanese, so I believe that's one of the reasons. But why did you choose Nagoya?
I came from Japan in 2001 year. And my first step is in Tokyo. I live in Tokyo for 2 years. I work in my first work, and I remember it's in the factory for six months. And next, I work in Tokyo International Press, in foreign air newspaper in Portuguese and in Spanish. Every time is I work in the office. My hobby in the office is the music, and I meet any people, the foreign people, introducing me in the area of the advertising, graphic design. Next, I live in Hiroshima for 2 years. I work in Mazda company in technical designs, the cars, the new cars for magazines. Next stop in Osaka for 2 years. Next in Mieken, Suzuka. Now I live in Nagoya for 4 years. Yes.
I see.
I hope you stay in this area.
So why? Well,
it's very curious because Nagoya for me, when my first time when I came to Japan, is Nagoya for me is Tokyo, a big city, wonderful city. It's very nice for me because I live in all my life in Bolivia and South America. It's very difficult. The people is go outside the country. I haven't really good luck in coming from Nagoya and up to Japan. And Nagoya is very special for me because it's a very quiet city, very nice people, friendly people. It's very easy the communication introduced for any place, anyway.
I see. So you kind of told me what your plan for the next year, but so you again, what your future plan for the next art?
Wow. I know, really I is a million question. Really, in my life, I never planning for the future. Really, I live in just the moment because I don't know what happened with my life tomorrow, next week. I'm sorry for many people, but it's my philosophy, my style. Never I planning for the future. I live in.
All right, so thank you very much, Eddie. I'm looking forward to seeing your work next year.
Yes, of course. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, James. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Pleasure.
So next, I'm going to have
Edward.
Yeah, I'm going to have Edward. No, whoever. Then I have Alex. Already coming and now. Sorry, Alex, we are kind of running behind. It's kind of UC. Sorry about that. So, Edward, please come in.
You should sit here. Sorry, I might just mention Matsumoto really quickly. Is that all right?
Follow it. Yeah, okay.
Sure. All right, thank you very much, everyone. This is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English, so that you can understand Japan more. Today is 1:03 p.m. Japan Standard Time on Saturday, November 5th, 2011, live from Nagoya, Japan, at Nagoya International Center, fourth floor exhibition room, doing the live cast of the Foreign Artists Exhibition to talk about all artists from amateur to professional to college students to according to James, some homeless people, but I don't know, I don't think so. So next we have Mr. Edward join his work. So hello, Edward.
Hi, nice to see you today.
Thank you for coming to talk to us. So
my pleasure.
Who are you?
Who am I? Indeed,
yes.
I'm Edward Scruggs, originally from Tennessee in the United States, which is exactly on the same line of longitude as Nagoya. So the weather is about the same. I feel right at home in Nagoya because of that.
So what do you do?
I'm a professor at a university here in Nagoya full-time.
Okay.
And I have a small photography business that is, thanks to the Nagoya Foreign Artist Show, has gotten some attention. I'm very grateful about that.
Cool. So why did you decide to join Foreign Artists Exhibition?
Well, this is my second year.
Okay.
And I was a bit tentative about it last year, and I had the pleasure of meeting James, who and all the other people here. We had such a really wonderful experience, the openness, the friendliness of the artists, the communication, that I decided to exhibit again, and they were kind enough to have me again. And that puts me here.
That's a very nice statement from Edward, because that's exactly our intention, to be a welcoming, warm environment for artists to come in, because many are showing their work for the first time. So in order to provide the best environment, of course, we're very light, helpful, drinking, and having fun.
That's right.
It's an important dimension.
I think that's what surprised me. When you get a bunch of artists together, everyone thought about ego. But there's very little of that. There's a lot of acceptance. We sometimes agree to disagree, but that's fine too. And
right.
it's done in a very civilized, creative, a very positive sort of environment. I think that's really a wonderful part of it.
Cool. So, Edward, what kind of art do you have?
Well, I do photography photo manipulation, and this year I'm something that I'm excited about is printing photographs on metal. And, it's very interesting. Instead of paper, metal has a very high reflectivity. It may be reflecting into your camera lens right now. I don't know.
It is.
But it allows more luminescence in the image that is possible on paper. Mm. And this is just one image of one of our lovely models holding an orange, and you can see the reflectivity here in the eye. So that's a sort of new medium.
This is the first time we've had this style of photography, and it's attracting a lot of attention.
I see. I actually
thank you for having it.
I actually went ahead film your stuff earlier, so I just want to show it to you that on the. So you do the montage photography, I believe.
I do it upon occasion. Yeah, I'm very influenced by the surrealists and the Dadaists. So I really enjoy surrealism is a lot. Dali especially was a big influence to me, just because I think it's fun. No real great intellectual force behind it. I found that type of image could be compelling and beautiful at the same time.
Very beautiful.
Thank you. I do have some prints on canvas. All right, that sort of image of Adam and Eve there, the wonderful model holding the apple with this very powerful man from Tonga representing Adam and Eve. Is actually printed on canvas, which I think is very handsome as a medium.
That's quite the contrast right there.
right. Okay. The apple of knowledge.
All right, awesome. So, So this is your second year. So, what you have learned, what you experienced from last year, and then what were you expecting this year, and what are you looking for from Brian Artist's exhibit?
Just as James mentioned. A few minutes ago, the variety of artists that are here. We have these lovely watercolors that we've seen from Barbara and all to installations. I think it just broadens our perspectives. We get to look and learn, and wouldn't miss it for the world now. It's absolutely a wonderful thing.
It's true. That's another process that happens. Artists learning from each other, particularly in the photographic field. Photographers just beginning to think of their work as art forms, suddenly being in the same room and same exhibition as long-term established people that have been photographers for a long time. It's a nice learning experience.
That's a good point. If you look at the Janssen History of Art, which is the big compendium standard work, it was only in about 1989, I think, that photography was actually included in the Janssen History as an art form. There was a lot of argument that it could never be an art form, that it was just reproducing reality, and that the artist had very little point there. But that's, I think that's not
it's
true
definitely
at all.
An art form. It's definitely an art form.
Mm-hmm. I see. Awesome. All right. Anything else that you want to?
Well, I might just mention really quickly that our image for this year is this one. I'd like to say thank you as many times as possible. Is Matsumoto Chiaki, who's a real very well known dancer here in Nagoya, and she was so kind to do this beautiful arabesque for us.
Oh, that's Chiaki Matsumoto.
It is.
How did you get her?
I didn't know her at all, and we met, we talked for about 10 minutes. I told her what the event was going to be like, and she is so kind and professional and has such a great sense of humor. And I'm going to tell the story again tomorrow night, but I have to say that when I asked her to do this pose, I said, you know, Chiaki, I'm going to ask you to be really still for about 3 seconds. And I thought that was really asking a lot. And she said, 3 minutes, no problem. And she absolutely assumed that arabesque, and it was just ease and grace, no problem at all. And we had a good laugh about it later. So that showed you how really powerful.
Another point, Edward, he's a very modest man. He's got an unbelievable amount of personal charm, particularly with attractive young women.
I wish that were true, but
it's true. We see it every day.
Feed my fantasy
every day.
That's great.
Do you have a Japanese wife?
I do.
Maybe you need to tell us a trick.
The trick. What's the trick? The trick with keeping a Japanese wife? Is that what you're asking?
Yeah.
Obedience.
Oh,
and everything.
That's really hard for some Japanese, the American people, I think.
But you mean you're obedient to
I'm
your
obedient
wife.
To her, right. Right. I would say, really, we have the most wonderful 10-year-old son on the planet. course, everybody does, but I think our son is what keeps us together. It's just wonderful being a parent, and they're really supportive.
I see. All right, cool. But by the way, Eddie, you were in front of the camera all the time. I can see your
kind
head.
Kind of nice seeing Eddie's head there.
That's much better than mine.
I should have switched the camera, by the way. But anyway, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Edward, thank you very much.
Thank you.
So I think, what? You want to go?
Well, it's up to you.
Do you need to pee?
Kat's here as the director of this
program. If you need to pee,
so I'm doing exactly what he's asking.
You can on your cup.
No, I've got a cup. It's all right.
So, Emma, if you need to go, you can go.
It's up to you. You tell me.
I kind of like you to stay, but...
Oh, really? Okay.
Because you are my kind of partner.
I can help if there's any.
Oh, it's too hot for you?
No.
Do you need to bring me a fan and fan you?
No, that's all right. Okay. I like the heat.
All right, everyone. So I think I don't want you to wait, Alex. So I think...
Keep going.
Oh.
Laura.
Laura. Okay, Laura then. So Laura, please come.
All right.
So everyone, this is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. I kind of want to repeat this segment because some viewer might have joined at the... during the segment. So I'm live from Nagoya International Center. Today is Saturday, November 5th, 2011, live from Nagoya International Center doing introduction of the Foreign Artists Exhibition 26. James Golter sitting in the center. He's the man in the house.
Yes.
And then now we have...
We love you.
Thank you very much. And I'm already very pink.
Then we have Laura.
Nice to meet you. Nice to Hello. Meet you.
Thank you very much. We kind of did keep having the no offense to everybody else. We kind of did have the two old men, so I kind of need to have some female appearance for the show to add some kind of color to the show. So thank you very much for being.
So
I heard that you were related to someone who's very important to this FAE. Who?
Yes, Barbara Casterline.
Oh,
she's one of the original founders. She's my mom.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So. What kind of art do you do, Laura?
Well, I do watercolors. Can I just show it to the camera?
Sure.
Like your
mother.
Yeah.
So by the way, why Barbara and you happen to be in Japan?
Well, I came here because my parents moved here, and I liked it here. So my sister moved to the United States, and she's still there.
Mm.
And as for me, I went back for a little while. I came back.
Mm.
I like it here.
Okay.
The people are kind.
Okay.
I could go on and on about wonderful things about Japan.
But sometimes you have to criticize Japan, though.
That's true too.
Yeah. So
what? Because I love Japan.
Yes. So what do you do? What do you do for living?
For a living.
Yeah.
Okay. I teach English and I do narration work.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, so
it's a lot of fun.
You are kind of. You're my profession then. Okay.
So
okay. So I actually filmed your artwork.
Uh-huh.
So I'm just gonna show it to the screen. So you do everything you have is the watercolor paint?
Yes. Actually I also use water based colored pencils that you just draw and use a brush and soften it.
Okay. I see. So why did you decide? Well, I kind of know because your family heavily involved to FAE. But why did you decide to exhibit your art as well to this foreign artist exhibition?
Well, I used to be a little bit shy about my art, actually. But there's something that I feel I want to share,
mm-hmm.
and that is that I feel that this world, this planet, needs more love, more peace, more mutual understanding. And so if I can share that and share what I have inside, it might be worthwhile.
Mm. It is worthwhile. It yes. definitely is
Thank
worthwhile.
By the way, you could a little bit face to the camera because okay. I want to see your face more.
So, all right, thank you.
But so no, nice work. So how many times have you display your work?
I think this is probably my 10th time.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
10 or 11 by now.
Really? Oh, awesome.
So I enjoy it. And one thing I really love about it is that there are so many cultures represented, and I feel like we can catch a little bit of an essence from looking at the artwork and just get a little bit of an understanding about different cultures.
Okay.
And so it's a unique opportunity.
I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, awesome. Again, once again, this time there are 18 countries represented
cool.
here.
I didn't know that.
From every continent except Africa, sadly. We have had African artists in the past, but it's difficult. It seems Africans don't spend very much time in the country or long enough to establish themselves.
Maybe someday.
Maybe oh, someday yes, 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 yes.
That would be great.
Yes.
If we're here long enough.
Yeah.
Laura, do you do exhibition outside this FAE?
Actually, in March, mid-March to mid-April, my mom and I are going to be exhibiting in a place called Gallery 350, which is a coffee shop near Ikesta. It's kind of a cool place, pastel colors and everything.
Yeah, so nice, good thing about the all over Japan, well, I mean, any places in the world, basically, but, you know, we have all the coffee shops that you can
Nagoya is famous for coffee shops.
Yes.
And morning sector, Ogura Toast, and things like that.
And so. Mountain, the crazy dessert, but we'll go into that other time. Maybe James and I can go eat sweet spaghetti or something later on. But,
hopefully something that's very fascinating. That's what I mean.
All right. So anything else that you wanna say? You have an announcement?
Yes. Love everybody, peace everybody, and have fun.
All right.
Okay, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you. So, nice. Thank you very much. So, I think Alex is your turn. Everyone, this is Katz from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com.
You don't need me.
Yeah. YokosoNews.com. And then, can you go find more artists? If anybody wants to talk, like in about 30 minutes or so.
Can you fix this painting?
So.
You're much better than
No, then I want Linda. I want Linda. I like Linda to sit as well to talk about the community part of this as well.
Thank you, Alex.
Alex, thank you. Thank you very much. I asked you about like last Tuesday to be here. Like, were you supposed to be working today?
I am now.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Oh, so I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna try to make it up as much as possible. Everyone, this is Katz from YokosoNews. We are live from Nagoya International Center, and this is the place where foreigners can come and receive their services. So I have the great representative from Nagoya International Center. And also, I want to welcome back Linda Taki to share about the international community of the Nagoya and how international community are doing in Japan. So if you have any question, if you're James, you have to learn. Okay, James, thank you very much from the New York. So let's talk about you guys are hosting the great event here, but what is the Nagoya International Center?
Well, We were founded in 1984 by the city of Nagoya to promote international community, internationalization in Nagoya, in the area.
Okay.
In 1984, there was only around 60,000 foreign residents in the whole of Aichi Prefecture. And since then, that's grown. Right now, there's around 200,000 foreign residents. It's number two in Japan behind Tokyo, Aichi, Osaka.
Mm. Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, so I thought Osaka was the second.
No, Aichi overtook it 2 or 3 years ago.
Oh, really? Oh, I didn't know that. Okay.
That's right. Nagoya City itself has around 70,000 foreign residents. So what we do is our services are open to everyone, both foreign and Japanese people. We're funded mostly by Nagoya City. So we offer service for foreign residents, just as a good helpline, kind of?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. So, like, if people come travel to Nagoya, the third floor of this Nagoya Kokusai Center, they have a great help desk.
Right.
So, I have the DVD. You have a consultation services.
Right, we have consultation services. We have a civic counselor who can tell you anything about the law in Japan, about services in Nagoya. We have an information counter where you can get information, tourist information, information about things to do in Nagoya, that kind of thing. We also have legal consultations with a lawyer.
Okay.
They're every Saturday. We also have personal consultations with native speaking counselors. Occasionally we have health consultations where a non-profit organization comes in here and gives dental and health checkups. We also have tax consultations. They'll be in January, February next year.
Yeah.
So if you have to.
Oh my God! You just gave me a headache.
It's gonna be tough for you. Yeah. We also have education counseling. Recently, we've done tours of universities and high schools for foreign nationals, foreign students who are looking to go into further education. And next month we have Gyosei Shoshi consultation.
Gyosei Shoshi, yes.
Yes. So it's the,
it's a lawyer in general, but yes.
It's a lawyer who can help you like start your business or help with your visa.
Incorporation, that's kind of paperwork related to something. So.
Right.
And you have a community service to the kids, local kids.
Right.
You also do events.
Right, right. We also...
like foreign artist exhibit.
We have this year, yes.
Yes.
We also, every Saturday, we also have a soccer class in Minato Ward, just for the local children. Recently, one of our old students, he's now actually playing in the J-League.
Really?
Yes.
Oh my God. J-League is Japan's professional soccer league. So that comes out, who came out from Nagoya International Center program. That's awesome. So you, in addition to the these services, then you guys also provide the information like calendar, who is the editor, Mr. Alex?
The Nagoya calendar.
Yeah. Who?
I'm the editor.
Oh, really? Oh, I didn't know. Okay, I'm sorry.
We also have a Portuguese edition.
Okay.
And we also have a Japanese one called the Nikkei News.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
So if you happen to live in Nagoya area, and if you happen to be foreigner who needs the little English help, and this is the place to be, I guess.
Right. Well, our services are free, and we have them in 8 languages.
Okay.
Yeah. We also have a great library.
Okay. Yes.
Right. We have around 30,000 books. Around a third are in English.
So what kind of consultation at the consultation desk on the third floor?
Right.
What kind of help they ask to, well, so I mean, so anybody, really anybody, I mean, you kind of already, I'm kind of repeating the same question, I'm sorry about that, but it's anything that, like, any question you can ask at the third floor, I guess.
Think of anything. Common questions are, how do I get married? How do I get divorced? How do I register my children? How do I sort out garbage? Japanese classes, where can I learn Japanese? That kind of thing.
Okay. So, Alex, how about you? Where are you from, Alex?
I'm from the UK.
Okay.
Yes.
Where?
A small town in the north of England.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry to ask you that. How long have you been in Japan?
In Japan, since 1997. Yes.
Oh, really?
Yeah. The day after Tony Blair became Prime Minister of the UK. Yeah.
Okay. That was a long time ago.
Long time ago.
Yes. So how? When did you start working at the NIC?
NIC was 5 years ago.
Oh, okay. How did you get this lucky job?
Is it a lucky job? I don't know. They needed help, and I answered the call. That was... Yeah.
Okay. So for 5 years, what do you like about this job? And
what do I like?
I think your boss is here, so you can tell your boss your complaint from in front of the camera.
Complaints? I don't bite the hand that feeds. So yeah, it's given me the opportunity to improve my Japanese. No one speaks to me in English, so I've got to speak in Japanese. I know Nagoya a lot more than I did before, and it's kind of opened my world up. There's more to the foreign community in Nagoya than the Western community.
Mm-hmm.
There's a whole lot of big Filipino community and big Brazilian and Peruvian communities.
Yeah. Before I started the YokosoNews 2, I didn't even understand the Japanese culture either, because I grew up like naturally without any like difference. Oh, were we that, you know, special compared to, I mean, different compared to the, you know, Western culture, that right. kind of stuff. So by being able to get into the international community, like international center here, and the events like this, you'll be able to kind of see the difference, and you actually can understand who you are more.
That's right.
So that's awesome. So Linda.
Yes.
Thank you for waiting. But so Linda, so you are the involved in Central Japan International Society.
Yes.
And what's the relationship to the Nagoya International Center? And you can briefly tell me about you can briefly tell me about.
Okay. It started first with the Foreign Committee, and the Foreign Committee was a steering committee to establish the Nagoya International Center. So that was 1983. Mm-hmm. So I was requested to be one of the members of this group and to recommend the activities for the foreigners here in the area.
Okay.
So after a year, Nagoya International Center was inaugurated, and many foreigners came. And the purpose was to gather foreigners and have cultural exchange and to improve their knowledge about the culture here in Japan. So we started to make events through the cooperation of Nagoya International Center. We have international parties, but then we thought of formalize the.
By the way, Linda. Okay. You look like you are stressed.
Okay, no, not stressed.
So,
okay.
I mean, you are like.
Okay.
Please take a deep breath.
Okay.
So.
Okay. It's okay.
Like you can like put your leg on the table and then.
Put your leg.
Just talk
okay.
about. I mean, take a deep breath. And
okay.
So but anyway, so. But Linda, you are also the Filipino.
Yes, I came from the Philippines, mm-hmm. and I've been living here for a long time.
Okay, would you tell me? So, Central Japan International Society cater to all kinds of people.
All foreigners. Yes.
So, what's the difference between the International Center of Nagoya and then CJIS? What's the difference?
What's the difference?
Yes.
It's the same. Central Japan International Society,
mm-hmm.
and it's the short word is CJIS.
Yes.
So this name was.
What's the difference? NIC, Nagoya International Center, provide the service here. But what do you do compared to Nagoya International Center?
We were charged
okay.
with creating activities
okay.
for cultural exchange.
Okay.
And so the foreigners who are new to Nagoya, we
okay.
feel better to live.
Okay.
And, okay.
Yeah, so Nagoya International Center has the building. You guys have a service. Then if people come here, they can receive the consultation service. And the CJIS create the events. Activity
that was at the start, so we were really forming the start of all the events of the International Center, which they have now.
Okay.
So, for example, the introduction of the Nagoya footsteps, we gathered together. We were maybe 10 or 12 people and thought of the contents of the brochure which Nagoya International Center has prepared now, and it has really improved with different languages. Before it was only English, and now they have already all the languages.
Yes, yes.
Okay.
I see. I had the question and kind of forgot just now.
Okay.
Dang it. what was I thinking?
CJIS brought the foreign viewpoint into International Center.
Yes.
International Center was Japanese.
Was still in the inauguration period, so it was changed.
Mm.
It was changed to Central Japan International Society, so it would become a formal group already. Before it was only a steering committee.
I see. Then Linda, would you explain to me what? So you are also the kind of representing Filipino community too. So would you explain to me what it's like the Filipino community in Nagoya?
the start. So I came here, and there was a really very few Filipino groups here, Filipinos here in the area. But then it started to grow, and the needs also and the problems started to grow. And so I assisted in the making activities for cultural exchange. So that's why every year I help to organize the Philippine International Festival, and it's usually held in Nagoya International Center. So this is also the 27th year. And so also I cooperate with the Nagoya International Center in getting the services, for example, the legal, and as Alex was saying, information on marriages, divorces, and the registration of children. So that's what I'm also doing, and also referring all the Filipinos who have real problems and they wanted to have more information about the area to come to Nagoya International Center. So it's more of a collaborating and cooperation between the Nagoya International Center and the Filipino community too.
Oh, but Alex, yes, now I remember the question I wanted to ask. I don't know if you can answer, but not only Nagoya, there is other international center like this. So so Sendai has one, and the Aichi prefecture has the Kokusai Koryu.
There's one in Yokohama.
Yokohama.
There's not very many big ones.
Yes.
This, yeah.
But if people have any question, anything, and any trouble, just try to find the nearby international center. But Nagoya International Center, I heard that you guys open to not only the people of Nagoya. If people want to ask some questions,
sure,
people
sure. can anyway, from anywhere.
Okay,
anywhere, any nationality in Japan.
Okay, from how about all over the world? No.
Yeah, we get international calls.
Oh, okay. Often. Okay, okay, okay. Then also, you do actually, when I was at the high school, students wanted to know about what to do to study in the U.S. You guys hold the seminar.
That's right.
To the Japanese high schoolers or wanna study in the U.S. or foreign country.
I think there's one actually today.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Look up me. Like, oh, okay. Okay, like 10 years ago, I couldn't speak
I think
any
it's,
English.
On the fifth floor.
Oh, okay, right? The one upstairs. Okay, I think I was one of the seminar like 10 something years ago, I think.
Right.
And I couldn't speak English, and then I didn't know what to do. I was a pure yet innocent Japanese guy who didn't know how to joke. But look at me, look at how I became because of Nagoya International Center.
Now you know how to joke.
Yeah.
Okay, joke.
Yeah, so thank you very much.
Welcome.
Anything that you missed to mention?
Yes, we also have a great website.
Oh, that's right, yes. NIC dot...
Something I prepared earlier.
Oh, nice!
Wow!
So you can search for us at The Nick. That will come up.
Yes.
Number one.
Sounds like they're going to prison.
The Nick, yes.
You can Facebook. Want
more closer, yeah.
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
The Facebook?
Facebook at The Nick. You can follow us on Twitter.
Yeah.
Oh. And we're on Facebook at Facebook.com/Nagoya International Center.
Okay.
Wow.
Yes. All right. Oh my God. Awesome. So you guys provide 8 languages on the website?
8 languages, Japanese, English, Portuguese, Spanish.
And also one of the important thing is that if you happen to have some natural disaster like typhoon,
right.
Last month, you guys did provide fantastic disaster information in the foreign language.
Right, we've got that on our website.
Because we had a flood
stuff. What's in Nagoya?
Where do you live? Can I ask you that?
I live on a hill in Warese.
Okay. So you were safe.
I had to walk home.
So if there is some emergency stuff happens, this is the place that you can also call.
Right, we have disaster manuals.
Okay.
What to do in an earthquake or typhoon, you can download from a website.
Yeah.
We also have a Twitter feed of updates.
Okay.
Of if there's any emergency in Nagoya.
Okay.
Right.
I see. So it sounds boring to some viewers, but when maybe have it in your mind.
When an earthquake happens, you'll be calling us. So.
Yes. Yes. Well, it really did. When the March 11th happened, I started the emergency broadcast 30 minutes after. Then I found the Senda International Center phone number, and then I gave out a couple people, and then it was a tough time. That right. March 11th.
It's a good idea to plan ahead.
Yep.
Yeah. We also have evacuation maps for all of Nagoya City.
Yep.
In English.
Yep.
Chinese and Portuguese. That you can download from our website.
Yep.
So it shows the your nearest evacuation shelter.
Okay.
Where you live.
Okay.
Or nearest safe area if there's a flood.
Okay.
So. Some safe areas aren't safe if there's a flood. They're kind of low ground.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. So, that's really important to know. So, all right. Anything else, Linda, that you forgot to mention?
What about the Central Japan?
Yeah.
One of our purposes is to have cultural exchange. So we have been making this art exhibition.
Okay.
And so thanks again to the cooperation of the Nagoya International Center for giving us this opportunity for the past 26 years.
Well, thank you for having me.
And thank you also to the YokosoNews.
Sure. Okay, yeah, you are the calendar guy. Yes, go ahead.
We have Christmas cards.
Oh, okay.
UNICEF Christmas cards.
Okay.
On sale.
Okay.
From November the 11th.
Okay.
We have 20 kinds of cards.
Okay.
They're 200 yen each. We also have a book recycling bazaar on November 13th.
Mm.
About 3,000 used books.
Okay.
They're on sale. The proceeds go to UNESCO to help promote literacy in the third world.
Okay.
It starts at 1 o'clock.
Okay.
You should be there at 12:30 if you want some books.
Okay.
Because they go fast.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bring books to show.
I have books to show. We have some great look books in the library.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Pride and Prejudice.
We also have manga in English.
Dragon Ball in English.
And we have a great selection of children's books.
Socks.
And the Japan Japanese language test is next month.
Oh,
they have a
JTL.
And we have some.
I'm only like level 5, by the way.
We have study books.
Oh,
wow.
Oh, so if you come to the Nagoya International Center, you don't have to buy a book.
No, that's why there's libraries.
Oh, okay.
Right. Buy all the books.
You can also there's also listening CDs for listening tests.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh.
So it's a great place to study as well.
Mm. What's your level, Alex?
Officially, it's level 2.
Oh my God! So you can read kanji?
The paper says I can read kanji. Yeah.
Oh, good. I cannot read kanji, by the way. I'm Japanese, so I cannot read kanji.
Really? Learn kanji first.
I need to take a test actually myself too. So
right.
Yeah. All right. So thank you very much, very much for Alex from Nagoya International Center and Linda from Central
thank
Japan
you
International
very much
Society.
Thank you.
All right, everyone, this is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English. I'm live from Nagoya, Japan, at the Nagoya International Center. So, sure. Okay. So we have more guests coming. So, Jan, you have to sit. Introduce her for me.
Is this right side up?
Yes.
Hello,
hi,
Jan.
Hello.
Jan,
nice
from
to see you again.
What is your official title for the FAE?
Jim's assistant. How about that? No, I also do the Spanish and Portuguese contacts because I can speak both of those.
Oh, okay.
So I do anything Jim can't do, I do. And I don't know. Yeah, probably Jim's assistant.
So you're secret.
The secret,
agent. Or
yeah, secret agent.
Yeah, okay.
That's me.
Good.
Yes,
all
secret
right.
agent.
So now secret agent has been revealed.
Yes. And one of secret agent's favorite people is Claire Shadler. She's an artist in this exhibition.
So Claire, thank you very much for being in front of the camera. But don't worry about it.
Relatively new gaijin in Nagoya.
Okay. So would you introduce yourself?
Sure. My name's Claire Shadler. I'm from the United States, and I've been in Japan for a year and a half.
Okay.
And I'm an English teacher here at Nagoya University of Foreign Studies.
Oh, okay.
With
oh.
Jan, actually.
Yes, me too.
Oh, okay.
Yes. That's what we really do.
Oh, so you guys are one of the smart English teachers in Nagoya, then?
Smart? Smart.
Yeah,
yes. There's many smart ones here.
Okay. So that's what you do for the living, the English teacher, but you happen to be involved in the foreign artist exhibit, I guess.
Yeah, so last year Jan invited me to participate, so
okay.
I joined.
So what kind of art do you have?
I do collage.
Okay.
So this is my second year in the exhibition, and both years I've done collage.
Okay. So let me see. Okay, so it looks so handmade, but and then he has a nice negative.
Thank you.
This is Claire's dreams.
Oh, okay.
This is a dream collection.
By the way, Mike is right behind your paper, so I cannot really hear you, Jan, if you speak.
This is Claire's dream collection.
I see.
Because at our university, we ask our students to write their dreams, to practice narration in English, and then Claire was inspired to write her own dreams.
I see.
So this is teacher's art.
which you could use to as a educational material to
for
the kids.
Students also do this sort of thing.
Yeah, yeah. Cool.
Become inspired by us, teachers out there.
I see. Claire. So yes. What made you decide to come to Japan?
I taught English in the United States as well, and I got my master's in California, and I had a lot of Japanese students that I worked with.
Okay.
Then and so
ESL.
ESL.
Okay.
Yep. So after my master's, I wanted to go abroad, and I looked at a couple of different countries and got a job here. So decided.
Where else? What was country?
I also looked in Azerbaijan and Costa Rica and Korea.
Okay.
But she also studied in China. She's been all over. She's very young, but very international.
I see. So it's been a year and a half, I heard. So what was your impression when you first time came, and then what, like, what's the most memorable experience that you can share?
There's a question.
That's a difficult one. I think my impression when I came was that life in Japan is very good. I feel like I enjoy my job, I like where I live, everything. I didn't have a lot of struggle or difficulty that maybe you might think you would have living in a foreign country. So I think that was my impression.
When the university introduced her to her new apartment, which is a typical Japanese, what, NLDK, you know, very small apartment, Claire said, "Wow, this is wonderful." She's the first person to do that.
Yeah. My boss thought I was just being polite. He said, "Really? Are you sure it's okay?" And I was like, "Yeah, this is great. I love it." So,
really?
Really.
So you went to the California, you went to the city, or?
I lived in San Francisco for a while, and then I went to grad school in Monterey, which is a small coastal town, like a couple hours.
And Monterey has the connection with Nagoya University of Foreign Studies. They have teacher exchanges, that sort of thing.
Okay, I see. Well, you live in San Francisco, so that's why you kind of used to having a smaller apartment.
Exactly, yeah.
That's what I figured, too, yes.
I lived in small apartments.
Yeah, okay, that's why. So, usually people are not really accustomed to the 2LDK apartment in Japan, unless you are in those city in the U.S.
Yes, exactly.
All right, cool. But anything that you got surprised, what's the advice that you want to kind of give to the viewer that you happen to move out to Japan, and what is there any stuff that you have in your mind that can come up with to give the advice to the people?
Advice to other foreign people coming to live in Japan?
Yeah, like English teachers, it could be English teachers.
I guess I would say advice would be learn as much Japanese as you can.
Okay.
I think as my Japanese is still pretty bad, but as it improves, I can talk to more people, and I think you can get more out of the experience of living here if you can speak Japanese.
Okay.
I mean, of course, you can get by with just English, but I definitely think you get more out of being here if you can speak some Japanese and actually talk to people.
Okay.
So that would definitely be my advice.
I'm sorry, I kind of ask you a question all over, but
that's okay.
Because I have applause from Joanne from New York.
Thank you.
So that was 30 minutes ago, so it was probably Alex, and I'm reading that comment right now. Sorry about that. Do you like living in Nagoya? So what do you like living? Did you go to other places in Japan?
I have. I've traveled a bunch of different Tokyo, Osaka.
Okay.
I've been down to Ishigakujima and Hiroshima. And
she goes to the extremes.
I just came back from Hiroshima a couple weeks ago too. So went to sake festival.
Mm-hmm.
So, but anyway. So what do you like Nagoya compared to other city?
I would say Nagoya isn't. For example, when I was in Tokyo, it seemed more international. There's more foreign people there. You can speak English easily, and it's okay. And I kind of like in Nagoya that it's not always, some people don't speak English, or maybe you have to.
You feel like you're in Japan.
You feel like you're in Japan. And not in an international city. And
well, it's getting international though compared to 20 years ago.
Yes.
When I,
people don't stare at you and point anymore if you're a foreigner. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
They're getting a little more politically correct.
I like that Nagoya just sort of feels like a normal city. It doesn't.
It's kind of right size.
One of the,
I remember when she and her husband went to Tokyo, and then they came back to Nagoya, and she said, "I'm really glad I live here."
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, you know what? One of the reasons I wanted to start YokosoNews in the Tokyo area is because Tokyo is too super crowded, too fast paced.
Yes, yes.
I kind of want to lay back and, you know, kick back and
relax.
Relax.
Yeah, you definitely can do that here.
Yeah.
It's a big city with a small town mentality.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Still a big city and it's still kind of moving. So that's what you can experience. So. All right, cool. So what's you coming back next year?
I do plan on coming back next year. Yep.
Cool. All right. Thank you very much,
Claire. Thanks for having me. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Claire. Next, Mr. Mike Romani. Hello, Mike.
Hi. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. Did I take your video? No, shoot, I didn't take your film. Sorry.
He has this.
So, yes. So, Mike, thank you very much for... Nice to see you again. I remember I interviewed you last year.
Right, that's
so,
right.
So, Mike Romani, who are you? And, sorry about that, but let me rephrase myself. Everyone, this is Katz from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japanese culture in English so that you can understand Japan more. Today is November 5th, Saturday, 2011. Live from Nagoya City, Aichi, Japan, we are at the Nagoya International Center, 4th floor, at the Foreign Artists Exhibition number 26. And we are welcoming people from all over the art exhibit. Now we have Mr. Mike Romani, the photographer, who has been working, like, this is how many times, Mike?
This is my fourth year to participate in this exhibition.
Okay. So what do you have today?
Today I'm exhibiting Kawasemi.
Oh, Kawasemi bar.
Yeah,
nice.
Kingfishers in English.
Actually, this is kind of the site, I kind of need you to get close to the camera. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, that's
like
good.
That?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool. So, nice.
Kingfishers and mandarin ducks. Oshidori.
So,
should I put some of these up in front of the camera?
Sure, if you
can
could.
See?
That's...
Is that working?
So,
yeah.
Cool.
So
sorry about that, Mike.
No problem.
Thank you.
Mandarin ducks.
Cool. So, Mike, we don't have to show much of the picture because we want people to come here to see your picture right in front of their eyes. But who are you? Where are you from and what do you do?
Okay, so I'm originally from West Springfield, Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. But I've lived in many places in the United States, including Atlanta, Georgia, San Francisco, Berkeley, Chicago area. And for the past 20 plus years, I've been living in Okazaki, Japan. And let's see. Yeah, so my wife is Japanese, and we have two sons. And I teach English in Okazaki. And as much as possible, I'm outside taking pictures in my free time.
I see. So why did you happen to be in Japan?
Well, let's see, I was living in California and the economy was bad. And
when was it?
1991.
Oh, okay.
And I lost my job. So I decided to move to my wife's hometown in Okazaki and teach English. And that's how I got here.
And, so you...
I plan to stay only 3 years and go back, but over 20 years later, I'm still here and not likely to return.
Well, do you like Okazaki? Okazaki, by the way, is about 30 minutes east of Nagoya City, which is kind of in between Nagoya and Tokyo. But it has, what does it have?
Let's see, it has a Hacho Miso factory.
Miso factory.
It's famous as the birthplace of Ieyasu Tokugawa, who united all Japan.
Yes, it created the Edo period for 400 years, okay?
Right. And so I really like Okazaki a lot. The people are very kind, and from Okazaki, it's very easy to quickly get down to Mikawa Bay or to go up into the mountains, and there's a lot of nature around, and so it's a very convenient place for me to take photos of birds. And so it's a very comfortable place to live.
I see. So, why did you decide to start taking pictures?
Well, I've always been interested in photography, but I couldn't really afford, you know, the camera gear and the film and the processing. But with the digital age and the improvement in the quality of cameras, then I decided to challenge. And about 6.5 years ago, I decided to get more serious about doing some kind of photography. But I couldn't find exactly what I wanted to do. Nature in general, but specifically, there aren't that many lions or tigers or bears in Japan.
Well,
so,
but,
you know,
but your picture has such a color, richness of the color to it. I think that's the one of the... not so many Japanese photographers can capture such a richness of the color much. So why did you... So you weren't really taking pictures in the United States?
No, oh, okay. Nothing so more kind of, than snapshots.
Oh, okay, so you kind of started in Japan. But what do you like about taking pictures in Japan?
Well, for me, since I'm focused on birds, then what I appreciate most about birds, I started with the larger birds, egrets and herons, and especially in ponds, and watching them dance and move their wings. Their grace attracted me, getting the reflections of them in flight in the water. That really interested me. And then in the last 2.5 years, I started to appreciate the beauty of colorful, smaller birds and the challenge of getting close enough to get a good shot of them. So, yeah.
You're getting better, I guess.
Yeah, hopefully so. Hopefully so.
Okay, cool. So,
but I learned all... The other thing about the bird photography, which I appreciate, is that it opened other doors for me. So I've been able to exhibit my work in various galleries. I've also been able to practice my Japanese because I meet other Japanese bird photographers who are far better than I am. And so I learned the bird names in Japanese first, and then I look them up and find out the English names for the birds.
So is there any advice to give it to like foreigners who wants to start taking that picture in Japan?
Yeah, I mean, everybody has their own little niche, you know, thing that interests them about photography, but I think Japan's a wonderful place to do many different types of photography.
Landscape
or street photography.
Yeah,
or
we have a city, nature. So four seasons.
Yeah. And many festivals.
That's correct. That's right.
But if you get interested in bird photography, you'll probably meet a lot of Japanese bird photographers. And it's a good opportunity to practice speaking Japanese, because most of them have no desire to speak English.
Cool. So what do you like about being in the Foreign Artist Exhibition?
Oh, it's a great place to meet other artists, photographers, and appreciate the vast variety, you know, that's here, you know, of that variety of talent and people from so many different countries and cultures coming together. And there's a lot to appreciate.
Cool. So, all right. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Anything that you wanna, you have an exhibit or outside is FAE that you wanna promote? Or?
No, I'm fine right now.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Cool.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Mike.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yay! So Jan, you have to be with me. So
I'm touching up. This
go
is
ahead.
We have many people from UK and from USA.
Okay.
Now we have our first Brazilian, but there are 15 Brazilians in this show.
Okay. Yes.
And this is Rodrigo.
Uh-huh. Rodrigo
speaks a little English, and he does caricatures.
This is, well, you have to show it to that camera.
Spock Obama.
Nice.
To get the reflection off. No, there
okay.
We go.
So, Rodrigo, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So,
Rodrigo Tsumura.
Tsumura-san. Yes. Would you introduce yourself, please? Your name?
My name is Tsumura Rodrigo Agents.
Okay.
I work and live in Japan for 10 years.
10 years. Okay. What do you do?
I'm working as an operator.
Operator.
Know, factory.
Yeah,
okay.
Factory.
Okay.
In Shizuoka.
At Shizuoka.
Shizuoka. Okay. And then, so why did you decide to be in a foreign artist exhibit?
That's where I first started taking. I don't show to people.
Huh?
I want to show to people.
Oh, you want to show your work to the people. So how many times this foreign artist exhibits?
My first time.
First time, okay. So what do you feel like?
A little happy.
Happy. Okay, good. Cool.
His plan for the future is make money in the factory and then become...
You have to see...
His plan for the future is to make money in the factory and then become a full-time artist.
Mm. Well...
It's to be illustrator.
I mean, you sure got the talent.
Thank you.
Yeah, so you just have to keep working, I guess. So cool. I guess. So Jan, I saw you guys doing some girls talk, Joshikai up there.
We had girls talk?
Yeah, I think a girls talk has to bring it to this place, I guess.
Girls talk?
Yeah.
You need girls talk?
Yeah, I think so. But anyway, so the Rodrigo, Rodrigo, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. So,
and good luck on your future as an artist.
Yes.
I don't want to give up.
Yes, never give up. Gambatte. As they say in Japanese, gambatte.
All right,
Thank you.
Carter! Hey, what's up? I'm doing a live test. Okay. Do you have your artwork? Oh, okay, cool.
Okay.
So,
you sit down. He said, I'll sit down. Okay, I'll sit down.
Yeah, okay.
Okay?
Sure.
Michael! So, would you introduce yourself, please?
Yeah, sure. My name is Mike Kutsu. I'm from the United States,
okay.
A very small state called Vermont.
Well, I know Vermont.
Yeah, it's very famous for maple syrup and snowboards and the Von Trapp family.
So, what do you have today?
I have amber. And this is how it all starts. It looks like this.
Actually, that's the camera, right?
The camera's right here. Okay.
Yeah, like you can really get close.
Right. Yeah. So here's a piece of natural amber.
Uh huh.
And you can see it's not very pretty.
Uh huh.
Here's another piece, just for fun, to show you what it looks like.
Yeah.
It looks like a combination of a piece of wood and a stone mixed together.
Uh huh.
So when you finish, though, it's quite pretty. Such
so
as
shiny.
This. Now this particular piece, I don't know how well you can see it, there's a bee.
You really have to place it right in front of the camera.
Can you see it?
Then now I need the focus to get little bit farther, more. Now the focus is your name tag because the character. But anyway,
we get the idea, right?
Yes.
Okay.
But that's why we need to ask people to come here.
Right.
So, absolutely. So I'm going to apologize. Yes.
To find a piece with a B in it is extremely unusual.
Uh-huh.
Perhaps one piece in 1,000 has a B.
Oh, that's so this, like, you kind of shove it, like, then
I polish it.
Well, you polish it and you found it.
That's right.
Oh my gosh.
When you start, when it looks like this, you have no idea
if
there's anything in it. There could be nothing in it.
Uh-huh.
There might be something extraordinary.
Oh my, okay.
That's the part of the fun. It's just like a lottery.
Where do you get these?
Well, this stuff here comes from South America. This is from Colombia, South America.
Okay.
But I have amber from many different countries.
Okay.
I have this piece here is from Colombia.
Okay.
This piece is a very unusual piece. It's probably the only one in Japan. This is a lizard.
Oh my God.
As you can see.
Oh my God.
Unfortunately, no matter how we show this on the screen, it won't show up very well.
Well, that's why people have to come here.
It's probably the only lizard in amber in Japan.
Oh, really?
There are only about 100 known to exist in the entire world.
Really?
Yes, they're very, very rare.
How did you find it?
Well, luck.
Oh my.
Now, this is from Madagascar. This particular one is from Madagascar, and it's got a very nice lizard in it.
Next time, I think you need to buy a lottery.
I'm not very good at that. But this was extremely unusual, yes. And I would say that the only chance anybody in Nagoya is going to have to see one is to come down here and see this.
Oh my! Oh, so okay. Can I take a look at it?
Sure. Oh, don't drop it.
Oh my God! I'm seeing the very rare amber in the world. Okay, thank you.
There you go. Okay.
All right.
Now, here's another unusual piece. Now this piece here, the only thing special about this is it's not the color or the shape or anything, but this is Mizunami amber. There's amber found in two places in Japan. Three places in Japan. Hokkaido is one. I don't have any from Hokkaido. But Iwate-ken has an amber called Kuji. And this is Mizunami amber. This is from Gifu. And they're very, very difficult to find because there's no digging going on.
Mm.
Mining for this is not something that people do in Japan.
Mm.
So this was found... This piece was found when they built the Chuo-sen, the JR's Chuo-sen, and it was found near where they have the station today, amongst other pieces. So this is unusual too. So if anybody wants to see Japanese amber, here they go.
So why did you get fascinated in those amber, and why do you do it in Japan?
Well, I do it in Japan because I live in Japan.
What do you do?
I'm an English teacher.
Oh, okay.
Who's not, right? Almost everybody is these days.
Well, we have a Boeing, we have a Toyota here, Toshiba, all kind of companies.
Yeah, but they're transient.
Yeah.
They just live here for a little while and they go home.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they make more money too. I don't know. I somehow missed my calling. But what happened is I found... there was a gentleman who was selling some of this copal, Colombian stuff, on eBay, and I bought some, and I tried it, and I found some great pieces, so I was hooked, and that was 10 years ago.
Mm.
So, and believe it or not, somebody's calling me on my telephone. I can't believe that. I guess I'll just turn off the sound. Nobody ever calls me except when I'm here. Whoops, how do you turn this thing off? There we go.
Okay. What the heck? Well, it's okay. Yeah.
Believe it or not, I get two phone calls, maybe three a week.
Okay.
And now, right in the middle of the program, yeah. I get a phone call.
Well, because someone's seen you, I think that's probably why.
Oh, that very well might be. Well, I'll call him back and ask him. So he's probably laughing. I called him and he was on TV.
No, it's not that.
So anyway, I have about 300 pieces here. From Indonesia, from Colombia, from Dominican Republic, from where else do we have? Four different types from Indonesia, Madagascar, and of course Japan, Kuji and Mizunami, and Mexico as well. And if people come, they can see. And they can buy a do-it-yourself kit.
Oh, okay.
I have a little do-it-yourself kit. They can get two pieces of Colombian that they can polish at home.
Huh. Okay. Cool. Sounds good. All right. Thank you very much, Mike.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Are you coming back next year?
Of course.
All right. So see you next year, maybe.
Yeah. Very good. Right. Thank you. Okay. Have a good one, everybody. Come down.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. So, yay. So next.
I'm getting you a drink, okay?
Okay.
No problem.
Hello. Hello everyone, this is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. YokosoNews is the online website to introduce Japan in English so that you can understand Japan more. We are live from Nagoya, Japan. We are at the Nagoya International Center doing the Foreign Artists Exhibition 26. Actually, why don't you guys sit here as a viewer and you can make an interruption, please. So the artist who lived in and around Nagoya comes around and introduce their artwork. Now, who we have here?
My name is Kim Malta.
Kim Malta.
Mr. Kim.
Nice to meet you. Where are you from?
Myanmar.
Hi. Oh, okay. So, what do you have here?
I'm an employee of the Under River Company, and I'm working here.
You work for Under River Company?
And I mean very Under River Company.
Okay.
Working there.
Okay. So, oh my God, you have very nice artwork. Is it the oil color painting?
Yeah, thank you. Yes, oil painting.
Oil painting. What's the theme?
So, this kind of painting, while I was visiting around Nagoya,
uh-huh.
One day I met South American music festival. There I found this girl. She's playing the harp, and then among with others, that time I feel something to draw her, and then I got a chance. Then I draw.
Did you get her phone number?
Oh, no, I but I have little bit changed her face.
Okay.
Yeah, of course, you know her.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, I mean, it's awesome. Well, so why did you decide to join this foreign artist exhibit?
So, actually, I have already full time for 4 years already, and this is the best chance for the foreigners to show their something on the thing,
yep,
to the people, and then we can also communicate with the native people,
yep,
and then we can exchange culture,
yep,
and then we show our something,
yep.
That is a good chance.
Yes,
yeah, that's why I try.
Yes, exactly. It's very awesome. Yeah. So. Awesome. So, yeah, I mean, I like it. You have a shell, and what's is that shell? The seashell, like and then cherry blossom.
This is the angel.
Angel. Oh, angel. Oh, I see. I see.
So
it's kind of hard
the
to
Eastern and Western style.
Yeah, it's kind of hard to see, but the yeah. looks like a shell, the small one. But it, when I take a close look, that's the angel. I see. I see. It's awesome. And then bird, bird humming on the sakura cherry blossom yes. tree, and yeah. then. Nice, nice. I like it. I like the gradient of the sky. And is a mountain in the back?
Yes. Because I've been somewhere in Japan. When I got a chance, I traveling around.
Uh-huh.
And I've been to Takayama.
Oh. Okay.
Yes, I've been to Takayama. Uh-huh. I this scenery I always in my mind.
Mm-hmm.
So a long mountain. The European mountain. But I see like this. This mountain side that with a little bit of snow. I feel mm-hmm. this. So mm-hmm. I combine everything what I like.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Jan, what is your comment?
My comment. I'm very happy that Mr. Keane is with us. We don't he's the first and only person from Myanmar that we've had at this exhibition, and we're really happy to have this contribution here.
Cool. Yeah. Sorry, I was talking to Linda.
He also wrote some poems over there and translated them into English and into Japanese.
Mm.
Yeah, he does a lot of work on his particular exhibit, and so we really appreciate that.
Cool. Thank you very much. Are you coming back next year?
Yes.
All right. So I'll see you next year.
Okay, see you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yay. So who's next?
We have Frances Marie.
Abby, I think you should sit. Yes.
One of our special volunteers.
Yes. You have to be in front of the camera sometime.
Another Filipina lady. When you talk, Abby, you gotta lower the picture to talk into the mic.
Yes. Frances.
Yes.
Nice to see you. So, would you introduce who you are and where you're from, and what do you do?
I'm Francis from France. I live in Mizunami, and I do this type of woodblock print.
Woodblock print.
Yeah, it's called hanga in Japanese.
Yes.
Woodblock print.
Nice.
With different colors.
Okay.
So you have to print the colors one after the other.
Mm. So what do you do for living, Francis? Well, if you don't want to talk, you don't have to talk.
I teach a little.
Okay.
And I have a job on the side.
Okay. So why did you decide to join the FAE?
Well, I joined every year since 2000.
Okay.
Yes. So it's a good opportunity mm-hmm. for the foreign artists to show their work.
Okay.
I could show like six works
okay.
this year.
Okay. So why did you decide to move to Japan first of all?
I first came a long time ago in 1990 mm-hmm. and I stayed 3 months, so I liked it and I renewed 3 months, and after that I renewed 3 months, and then when I couldn't stay anymore I decided to learn Japanese and mm-hmm. stay for 1 year, etc. And after 1 year, I met many people, so it became more and more interesting. So, and I finally entered the University of Art and established in Japan.
Okay, okay.
So I had an interest in the Japanese woodblock print.
Okay, okay. I see. So the ukiyo-e. Yes. That was how long ago?
Well, it's in 1990, so it's almost 20 years
ago. Oh my god!
Yeah.
Oh my god! So how many times have you lived? Have you come to FAE?
Since 2000, so 11 times.
So why do you like what do you like about this FAE? First of all, how did you get involved?
I was introduced by some friend.
Okay.
Who was exhibiting already.
Uh-huh.
And he told me, yes, you can join if you want, and that's a good experience, etc. So I liked the volunteers, they were very nice and helpful. Yes. And that's how it started.
Cool.
And it's a good occasion to meet many other artists or
yes.
foreign people.
Yes.
Have contacts.
So what did you learn and what did you learn from it? Well, you kind of mentioned you met with other people,
yes.
You met from the different culture.
Right. It's hard to resume in a few words, and not many things.
Well, you can pick some.
I learned. I contacted many people, and I could see their art, and they could see mine, and we could discuss, etc. And one good thing is I met an African artist, and we made an artist group together. It's called Marafiki.
Mm. I see.
We have an artist group, and we do exhibitions together.
I see. Cool. So you can build the collaboration. You can bring it to the next level from the foreign artist exhibit, and you can establish yourself. And that's awesome. Do you do any other like exhibit outside of the FAE?
Yes, I do. Actually, I do in my hometown. My hometown is Mizunami.
Okay.
And every year I exhibit in the coffee shop there.
Oh, okay.
And sometimes I do in other cities around in the area.
Okay. Cool. So if anyone wanna see more of Francis' work, and do you have like a permanent residency of the cafe? Like, do you have the regular cafe that you display your artwork at the Mizunami?
Yes, it's called Time Cafe.
Time Cafe in the Mizunami. All right, cool.
It's
so
each year, usually in October.
Usually in October. Okay. Cool. All right, Francis. Anything else that you want to say?
Well, I do things. To explain a little about this picture,
sure.
It's from Manet, a French painter of the 19th century, and I mixed with the Aboriginal style.
Oh, okay. I see.
This is my style. I mix different types of arts.
Because you're in Japan, you are influenced by the Japanese culture and then the kind of the mix, I guess.
Somehow, but it's mixed with Aboriginals, so I'm influenced by the South Sea cultures or styles. Yes. That's
okay.
All.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Who's next?
I think Albi.
Abby.
Sorry, Abby.
Hello. Yes. Hi.
Okay, Francis. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Really?
Kazuko-san.
Oh.
Is it okay?
Thank you. Abby, you
what?
Have to be here.
Really? No.
I wanted someone to explain this, so I have a Japanese student.
Oh, sure.
Who knows kanji really well.
Hold on. Abby, you have to be here.
Really?
Yes. But, Shoko-san.
Shoko-san.
Shoko-san. Yeah, just.
I'm moving.
This is artwork by an artist named Herman Pikus.
Okay.
And we need Shoko to explain what it says. It's written down here, but just tell us. It's very interesting. It's been in the background during your entire show, so.
So we actually have the great artwork in the background called Mr. Herman
Pikus.
From UK, the kind of abstract painting. So
it's actually kanji, the Japanese language. And he's he's made the kanji into pictures.
Sorry, カメラでさ、ちょっと上にパンして。Oh, that's. I see. That's. Oh, so.
Moving away.
What's this?
Shinjitsu wa. Aki.
Laka. Kayana.
Say into the mic.
Yeah, it's okay. I'm kind of repeating to myself. Oh, so the truth is being revealed or something. Oh.
Truth will be revealed.
Yeah, read the whole thing into the mic.
It's okay. I caught it all.
Let it be on camera.
真実は真実は明らかになる。
So then this one is the it's kind of 感じて feel it. I see. This is awesome. This is the all the Chinese character. こっちよこっちお願い。Oh, this is awesome. 超 it's the kind of overcome.Oh, nice. Oh, this is kanji.
This one.
I was wondering what was it, and then the one on the left.
What does that say?
The camera. The camera. My camera is kind of behind, so it's okay. Just 戻してくれたらいいわ。ごめん。戻してくれたらいいわ。はい、ありがとう。Thank you. Okay. So. Oh, nice.
And Shoko is a volunteer, and so is Abby.
Yes.
Thank you. Shoko-san.
Hi.
英語喋れる？
いや、あまり喋れない。
あ、喋れない。
Shoko is very good.
Oh, Shoko-san. So, who are you?
I'm a student at Nagoya University of Foreign Studies.
Oh, really? So you here as a volunteer?
Yeah.
So what do you feel like to see all this artwork?
All artwork is very funny.
funny.
Not as it is different from Japanese art and or this art, so I feel very funny, interesting.
I see.
Very interesting.
Abby.
Oh.
So yes. You're the volunteer.
Yes. So, I'm also a volunteer.
How long have you guys been involved in the foreign artists exhibit?
I've been volunteering. How many years now? Maybe 5 years.
Okay.
Around 5 years.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
First time. Yes.
So why do you like to keep volunteering? How many times have you?
First time.
Okay. So how do you like? Why do you come back here and keep volunteering? Then what's the impression of these artists?
Well, I really like the whole exhibit because uh-huh. it's it shows a lot of different kinds of art. Uh-huh. The first time I volunteered, I was expecting everybody was just gonna have some tired old paintings. But when I got here, I saw so many different kinds of art forms, including sculptures. Before, we even had a guy who was making sculptures from newspapers. So that was pretty interesting. And also, the people are so nice. Jan is not scary at all.
Yeah, no. Although people say I am scary.
Yes, no, not at all. She made me say that. And the people are really, really nice, honestly. And I met a lot of friends here. Meet new people, keep in touch with old people, old friends. There you go.
Shoko-san, just come here. Shoko-san, so this is first day or how many days?
3 days.
3 days. So last 3 days you worked, you kind of volunteer here. So what is your impression?
Same as her.
Okay. That's easy question. That's easy answer. That's called kind of cheating.
Very cool artist.
International experience.
Hey, no help. No English help.
Can you talk about more? Do you know more artists? There's no more artists.
Oh, really?
Talk about volunteering. One is composing himself.
Oh, okay.
So he's very nervous and afraid to come out.
Oh, okay.
So may I ask you something?
I have to get somebody come again.
No, I think we can wrap thing up. So
one guy is preparing to come.
No,
out. He'd rather not.
Oh, okay.
Claire wants to talk about her picture. We talked about Claire's life. It's about her dreams. Don't you want to hear about her dreams? Edward and Claire can talk about their dreams because he has an installation of dreams and Claire has a collage of dreams. You're not interested? Don't you have dreams? You never sleep. That's your problem.
Yeah, I didn't sleep last night. So.
I'll make an appeal for people to come here.
Please.
Sure. So I think we can start wrapping up.
Thank you very much.
Talking
about volunteering.
Okay. So, Kazuko-san, ごめんね.
I really am not scary.
Come to me. Sorry. I kind of asked. It's okay. Anyway, go ahead.
Yeah, go ahead.
No, it's okay. Go ahead.
Yes, as you probably heard, we rely on the Nagoya Kokusai Center for its kindness in giving the space to put the show on. But that means they like to see as many of the public come into this building as possible, especially the tax-paying public. So we always have a target. The target for visitors, not for artists, but for visitors. And we like to average about 1,000 people. This year, we're on target for that. Sometimes we fall below 1,000, and that's when we get a little bit worried because we think that the Nagoya International staff will think that our exhibition is
It's okay though, but we now have an internet appearance to the rest of the world, so we try to beat...
Well, it's true, yeah. Hopefully you've got thousands of people watching us. But this year it looks very good for visitors. So I think thanks.
Thank you.
No problem.
YokosoNews. It's really like a shot in the arm for us.
Thank you. Just one of the way to expand the opportunity for the artist and everything. So I'm glad to be able to to serve the part of the service to you guys.
Well, so. What would be nice if you could get an ordinary visitor, somebody who's not an artist, who's not a friend of an artist, but just came to see what
see,
our exhibition
please, here,
was
please
about.
Around. Find
so
somebody.
If you could find somebody who's here.
An ordinary visitor. No.
Because we're all biased. You know, we're inside organizing or doing our art.
Oh, yes.
We're biased. So a visitor, if there is one, I think Jan might be looking for one, who could sit here and say, this is a waste of time. Or we really enjoyed coming here.
It's not a waste of time.
So a whole range of
yes.
opinions.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because we do have, as you know, we have a lot of fun doing this. So it's a little bit selfish as well.
But so what's really let's talk about being the art and being in the Japan. So what's challenging to do the art in Japan? Or is it easy or challenging?
Well,
where are you from, Jim?
I'm an Englishman.
From UK?
I'm an Englishman, yeah. UK and England, not Scotland, Wales, but
okay.
England.
Okay.
For me, I was already very interested in art before I came here, so the challenge would be in not being an artist. Japan is such a visually stimulating place to be. The challenge is not to do art. Everywhere I look.
An ordinary visitor has arrived.
We have a visitor. Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
She speaks
Thanks.
English.
Yeah, no, Jim, you should help me interview her because
it's a good point.
Yeah,
it's a good point.
Thank you for being in the internet broadcast. Don't worry, your face is now broadcasted to the all over the world.
But don't worry about it.
So, but don't worry about it. Don't be shy.
That's true.
Don't be shy. It just your face is
but
in the screen. But nobody is really watching. So don't worry about it. So thank you for being in the interview. I heard that you're just a regular kind of visitor to the gallery.
Yes.
So what do you? Who are you?
I'm no more Japanese.
Oh, okay, no more Japanese.
Yes, I'm Yumi.
Yumi-san, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So what do you like about it's first time to be here?
Actually, it's second time.
Second year. Last year and this year?
This year,
second time this year.
Yes.
Oh, okay, so what do you like? What did you find? And what do you like about this exhibit?
I like art.
Uh-huh.
And I like watching Tenji,
Tenji exhibition.
Exhibition. And I was just looking around this exhibition.
Uh-huh.
And
is it same or different or
not different?
Like, do you find it different from regular art show by Japanese people or same?
Okay. What piece of art did you like?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. What was the piece that sticks in your memory?
I love Over There So Mass production.
Laura Castellan.
Yes.
Okay. I'm sure she's very happy. She can hear you. So.
I thought her art very. Gentle,
kind.
And it was very colorful. Mm-hmm. I love that.
Okay, how do you feel about the photography?
Photography?
Yeah.
I watched two pictures of Brazilian guys.
No. Brazilian?
Mm-hmm. I don't know who, but I like that.
What was the subject, the theme, tema of the picture?
Actually, I didn't see it, but... I watched it, but the title, I didn't.
I see. So the subject. Mm.
So in the picture.
What is in the picture?
Ah, woman. Woman.
Lipsticks. Okay.
Right. Do you think you would come next year if you saw in the newspaper or YokosoNews?
Do you like to come back next year?
Yes, I would like to come.
Okay.
And bring your friends?
Maybe, because I've just moved to Nagoya.
Okay.
I don't have many friends, so maybe
you can be everybody's friend now.
Thank you.
But I'm sure by next year, it's 12 months away. You'll have some friends, for sure.
Yeah, I was
quite
happy.
Cool. All right.
Volunteer? Excellent. Ina.
Go volunteers.
All right, cool.
Thank
you very much, Yumi-san.
Thank you very much.
Actually, we have a reporter from YokosoNews reporter stand by, the guy. So I think I need guy. I'm looking at you. Yeah, Paul. Please come, Paul.
Yumi-san, thank you for everything.
Arigatou gozaimashita. I think sometimes we need a young guy's opinion. So I think I'm inviting Japanese young guy. Come on, Paul. No, you have to be here. Oh.
By the way, we've just topped 600 visitors, so it's going very well this year.
Okay, good. Paul!
Nice to meet you. Hello.
James Paul. Paul has been the reporter of YokosoNews, and I kind of invited him and to come to check this guy's event.
Yeah.
Paul, did you take a look at the art?
Just a little bit. Just to walk around, and I'm hearing your news at the same time, so I didn't check it. I like them.
Okay. You kind of should have. I kind of sent you a message that I wanted you to take a look and give me an opinion. But
I thought I need to help something.
Yes. So now you're helping me to give me the opinion of the art, but it's okay. Is it your first time to come to
here?
This one?
Yes, this one is first time.
Okay. So because we actually met in LA. When I was back in LA like long time ago. But anyway, and happened to be in Nagoya area at the same time. So it's such a coincidence. Okay. And we kind of drink buddy. But
that's good.
Yes.
Please do.
What do you like about which art did you like? What kind of art are you impressed most?
Like photos. I didn't see the name yet.
No. Okay. Right. Okay. There are 60 artists here and about 30 using some sort of photography.
I see.
So there's a lot of photographs to see.
So I know you are going to all kinds of the club concert.
No.
Get drunk and post a photo on the Facebook. Like you sing a song, you skip a Halloween party and sing a song.
I'm so sorry about that.
I'm in a sandwich here. We often have people asking if they can take a photograph of the art to send to their friends or to put on Facebook. And my answer is always, yes, please take photographs of the work here and send.
Mm.
And I'm sure all the artists are happy as well that more people see the work through Facebook.
Mm.
It's good to hear. Or anything, yeah.
Mm. So
I allowed to take picture all of the
please,
art.
Please, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. Mm-hmm. So, Paul-san, why do you think it's important to have this kind of the exhibit? Actually, I already kind of said this exhibit is important, and I kind of could have asked you the question. That, but anyway, I mean, I'm bad. I haven't slept last night, so that's an excuse.
So, just my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
For me, if we are to be busy for our regular stuff, like walking and spending time with family, and I tend to forget those fun stuff, art, music, everything. So having those exhibitions and certain times in a year can remind of how fun it is and how good it is.
Appreciate to the art.
Yes.
And why does it, why are you sweating?
In front of cameras.
It's not the cameras. The cameras are very cool. The lights are like
yes.
Sauna.
Yes.
So, but anyway, I'm sorry. I'm kind of teasing you.
It's a good question. A very good question. Why are you sweating?
Why the international this is the international art show, and I kind of invited you to be here. Do you know why?
You want to see me sweating?
Yeah.
Very successful. But it's a good question. I mean, do you know why Katsu-san asked you to come here?
Well, you already answered one, to appreciate the art, but also at the same time, we can actually witness the different perspective of the culture and then influence how, you know, we can actually see how Japan is influencing all over the world in one place by seeing the, you know, foreigners in Japan. So that's actually kind of the mirror of how Japan is reflecting to the world. So for Japanese themselves, it's really important to, and is it one of the best chance to be able to see and appreciate and understand the effect of the culture, but at the same time, also the foreign people, then we actually can also interact, and the foreigner also can interact with the people in Japan, and then one of the chances outside of the club.
Yeah, not only about drunk.
When you are not drunk, then you actually can appreciate and enjoy intellectually, not alcoholic.
That's right. We try and strike a balance between a little bit of drinking,
yeah,
but a lot of art.
Yes.
A lot of conversation.
Yeah. Yes.
So it's cultural, it's social, and it's fun.
Yeah. And fun. You kind of making me look like I'm smart.
No problem. Very easy to do. But truly, thanks for this.
We've
all enjoyed this, and I think 14. I think it's 14 artists have been on YokosoNews
and
had their efforts
broadcast
around the world.
Yeah, it's a small record archive to the this event. So it's not. I mean, I really, this is not really like number. We don't really have a lot of viewership, but I just wanted to share with you, to the viewer, that you know, we it might not be the best of the all best work of the art, but more importantly, this is the where we create the community of then interact with the other people. So and enjoy doing the art. So I really appreciate Central Japan International Society and Nagoya International Center and Mr. James F. Golder to this do this event. Jan, Linda, and then I'm kind of wrapping up the show. I think Jan, can I wrap up the show?
Yeah.
Janet, Linda, Linda, can I wrap up the show?
Yes.
You don't have You don't have to be in front of the camera. So, Paul.
Hi.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Paul, nice to see you.
Thank you very much.
I hope you can see all of the work today.
Yes.
Please, please.
And you have to give us like a 10 pages report by tonight.
Pencil.
So,
yes, it's really a very good job, Katz.
No. Jan,
come here.
Come.
Yes.
Maybe you can share the chair with
Linda. Yes, I'll sit in between.
We'll share the mic.
Okay.
It's so cozy.
Yes.
Hello, my friends.
Yes.
There's that disembodied hand we always see in the photographs, and they think it's from the spirit world.
Yeah.
Do you see that?
That's good.
Do you like that?
Somebody once asked why
we're
you
bored.
Only have one show a year.
So everyone,
and our answer was that we want long lives.
Everyone, this is Kat from YokosoNews, YokosoNews.com. Today is November 5th, Saturday at 2:53 p.m. Japan Standard Time. Live from Nagoya, Aichi, Japan, we are at the Nagoya International Center. They are having the Foreign Artists Exhibit. This is the 26th annual art exhibit, like 60 artists?
62 artists
yes. From 19 countries. Came together and then exhibit their art, not only displaying their artwork but also to show artwork to then communicate and get involved in the community. So that's what it's all about. Joanne, thank you. It was a great show. Time for some curry, Kat. Oh, okay. Anyway.
Thank you, Kat.
Thank you, Joanne.
Bed. Yeah, I know. I have.
That's why he's wearing his pajamas.
Yeah,
you thought you were going to be able to sleep here, didn't
thank
you?
Are you okay?
Forget that.
Maybe we got some tie.
No. So, James, who you are last?
I'm last. Yes.
Introduce yourself to last as a credit.
Oh. Ah, okay. Well, yeah. Personally, my name is James Gota. I'm from England. I've lived here for a very long time.
And in your car.
Next to me. Not
and
in my
you
car.
Are the organizer of this foreign artists exhibit?
Kind of.
To get their.
We three.
Linda here.
Yeah, Linda.
Three. We're the big three.
Linda Taki, you are. What's the official title?
It's the chairman of the Central Japan International Society.
Chairman of the Central Japan International Society, Ms. Linda Taki, yeah, and Jan Gubbins.
I'm secretary of the Central Japan International Society.
And secret agent?
And secret agent of Nagoya International Center.
Oh, okay.
I love this place.
Oh, okay.
I would live here if I could.
Yes. And often we do. Just don't tell them.
Okay, we're the same age as you, Kat.
Huh? Oh, we're all the same age. Perhaps you'd like to know that.
We are like 21 years old.
If you add up three of Kat's, you get one of us.
Yeah, one and a half.
It's a.
And we're
one and a half.
International. We're from Asia, Europe, and North America.
That's
so
right.
It's pretty wide stuff. But we ourselves are not very wide. We've remained trim.
Yes. We're all in tip top condition from hanging all that art.
All right, anyway, so time to wrap up the show. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.